In this example, in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the current in this 4 ohm resistance. Now, to analyze this circuit, here we can consider this 12 volt cell with an internal resistance of 3 ohms and 18 volt cell with an internal resistance of 6 ohms. However, these can be ideal cells, but in the situation to analyze, we can also treat this with the cells and the internal resistance combination. In this situation, say if these terminals are X and Y, then we can write here, we can treat 12 volt 3 ohm cell in parallel combination with 18 volt 6 ohm cell. This implies here we can use the equivalent resistance, and the expression we already know, that is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 upon 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. But in this situation, you can see that 18 volt cell and 12 volt cell are oppositely connected. These are not connected in the similar fashion. So here we can write it as 12 by 3 minus 18 by 6 divided by 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6. And on further simplifying, you can see this will be 4 minus 3. So this will be 1 divided by 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 is 1 by 2. So this will be a 2 volt EMF that will be connected across terminals X and Y. So, in this situation, we can see that the equivalent EMF is 2 volt, which is connected across X and Y. So, this can be redrawn as, here you can see, we have taken this 12 volt positive and the result is positive. That means, the high potential end of this equivalent battery will be connected to X. So, this will be 2 volt and there will be an internal resistance connected to terminal Y, and there is a 4 ohm resistance which is connected over here. And this internal resistance R equivalent can be taken as 3 ohm in parallel with 6 ohm. That will be 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6, that is 18 by 9. It is also 2 ohms. So if this 4 ohm cell is connected across it, we can directly write the current flowing in this 4 ohm resistance will be, the potential difference is 2 divided by 4 and 2 in series combination. This will be 6, that is 1 by 3 ampere. That will be the answer to this problem.